By now, you should have a fairly good understanding of what Twitter is and how to achieve success with it. You know what Twitter's strengths are, you know how to set up an account, and you know how to make this part of a larger brand and synergistic digital marketing strategy. Also, you have created lots of inroads to your brand and ensured there are plenty of ways for people to find you. On top of that, you are now filling your account with great content that will attract more followers, keep existing followers interested, and encourage lots of retweets and shares. This alone is enough to ensure that you have a steady momentum and that your blog will grow over time. Unfortunately, though, it's still going to be a slow process if that's all you're doing, and it still involves a lot of work. That's why these next two videos are so important. This video is about working smart with Twitter instead of working hard. It's about streamlining your Twitter workflow, and it's about learning how to get more done in less time. Better yet, the next video is about finding ways to hack your growth and to jump straight to the top, leapfrogging your competition along the way. For those who have read the 4-Hour Workweek, this approach should be fairly familiar. This is about applying that 80-20 rule to your Twitter marketing efforts and putting more time into the aspects that get the real results. At the start of this series, we mentioned how Twitter had grown and now came with a host of tools and other features that you could benefit from, making it even more powerful. The following are just some tools that you can start using to make succeeding on Twitter that much easier and that much less work. First of all, there's Buffer. Buffer is a very simple tool that Twitter fans love. The idea is that you can buffer your tweets, essentially by queuing them so that they post automatically at set times. The thing to recognize here is that having a Twitter account that is completely quiet and empty is one of the worst mistakes that you can make. If your Twitter account has been abandoned and you haven't posted anything in the last 2 months, this will lead people to wonder whether you might have gone out of business. In the best case scenario, it will look as though you don't have the resources or the know-how to use Twitter, or as though you don't understand its importance. In short, it'll make you look unprofessional and thereby do more damage than having no Twitter account at all. Buffer gets around this problem by guaranteeing a steady flow of content, while also reducing the amount of time that you spend creating it. That's because you can set aside a few hours and write, say, 1,000 generic Twitter posts, and then let them be published every day for the next 1,000 days. No matter what happens, your Twitter will never be empty. And you can sign up at buffer.com. Then there's Hootsuite. And Hootsuite is not one social media tool, but really several built into one very convenient platform. And it has a lot of powerful features. For starters, Hootsuite could do everything that Buffer can. Buffer is better suited to people who don't want to deal with all the complicated functions available through Hootsuite. But at the same time, Hootsuite does let you manage multiple accounts. It lets you see various different social media streams in one place, and it lets more than one person log in, which can be very useful for teams who share their media duties. It makes cross-posting useful, and it even emails you with free reports. If you're serious about your social media and you've been around long enough to have a basic understanding of how it all works, then you should find that Hootsuite helps to streamline the whole process for you. This is a paid-for service, but at the time that I'm making this video, there is a 30-day free trial offer, and you can find out more at hootsuite.com. Another tool is IFTTT. Enough good things cannot be said about this incredible tool. IFTTT stands for If This Then That, a familiar phrase to anyone with a little experience in programming. What this does is to list all your different social media accounts and all your online apps together by creating recipes. Recipes are comprised of some kind of trigger event and an action that this causes. So for example, you can set up a recipe so that every time you post a comment to Facebook, it's also posted to Twitter. But it gets far more advanced than that. You can set up IFTTT to save all your tweets to a spreadsheet on Google Drive. You could also get IFTTT to share Instagram photos with a certain tag to Twitter, so that only certain types of content get shared. You can even do things like controlling the temperature of your house via Nest by sending emails. This is an incredibly powerful tool and has almost unlimited uses. Think creatively and you should find it has plenty of potential for your Twitter marketing campaign. How about setting up IFTTT so that topics that get upvoted enough in a certain subreddit get shared to your Twitter? That way, you'll have completely automated and highly relevant content for your Twitter account. And you can sign up at ifttt.com. Finally, there's BuzzSumo. BuzzSumo is a tool that allows you to quickly find content in a specific niche that's performing well on social media. Once you're using the tool, you'll be able to easily browse through various different posts that are getting a lot of attention. From there, you can share them to your own social media accounts. This is useful because it saves time and provides a quick and simple way for you to find more content. What's even better, though, is that you know this content is performing well and getting lots of shares, so it's likely to get you lots of shares too. Even if you don't share the actual content on BuzzSumo, you can always use it just to see what kinds of things are performing well. This way, you can get ideas for your own type of content and get a quick overview of how your niche or industry is performing. And you can find out more here at buzzsumo.com. A word of warning though, don't overdo the automation. If you use the right combination of tools and settings, then you should find that you can automate a great deal of your Twitter marketing. Even if you don't write regular posts anymore, your Twitter will now be populated with content on a recurring basis using Buffer, every time you post a new blog, every time you post a new YouTube video or like a YouTube video, every time something good comes up on Reddit, every time you post to Facebook, whenever you post to Instagram. Some marketers will even take this one step further and will have their Twitter accounts respond to comments automatically using bots. Now that's a lot of auto-generated content and a lot of time saved and generally a great way to maximize your ROI for the time that you're putting in. But don't get too reliant on these methods for filling your needs. If you do this, you can end up with a social media channel that's entirely soulless and doesn't add any real value. Gone will be the personal insights, the tailored content to your market, or the lifestyle promotion that we discussed earlier. The same wording will be used every time for certain actions too. For example, I liked a video on YouTube, and then you have the URL. What's worse, you might even end up with duplicates of the same content or with content that doesn't quite make any sense. If you use Buffer too much, you'll end up with content that doesn't express your mood, that doesn't reflect what's in the news and is just frankly generic. It'll lack the spontaneity or relevance of content that you upload yourself. With Buffer, the posts come at the same time every day as well, and this alone can be enough to prevent those posts from seeming natural and organic. People will be able to tell you if your Twitter posts have no personality, so don't let this happen, and use these auto-generation techniques sparingly. This is only for keeping your social media channels active. The life and soul will come from you actually writing new content and reacting to what's going on in your life. There is a way you can create a compromise situation and streamline the process of uploading content and avoiding periods of no new posts, but while still writing it yourself. The simple trick is to download some apps for your various social media accounts, such as Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram, and the official ones usually work best. Now it's really easy for you to comment on something that's happening or is on your mind, and it should only take a couple of minutes to do this whenever the inspiration strikes. And to prevent yourself from forgetting to do this, you can also set up some times of the day and some rules as to when and how you're going to post. For example, how about making the decision to post new content every time you go to the kitchen to make a cup of tea? You could even make this easier by having a separate tablet or smartphone just for posting to those accounts. Try taking an old Android tablet and keeping it in your kitchen with the Twitter app installed, or even leaving it on your assistant if you're not too worried about hygiene. While it's not a separate app or tool, Twitter Analytics is a very powerful force multiplier that belongs in your strategy and which can greatly enhance your effectiveness. To find Twitter Analytics, simply go to analytics.twitter.com/about. From here, you'll be able to log in and find your account statistics, and these will show you how you've been performing over the past month. These include tweets, how many tweets you've posted in that month. Tweet impressions, how many times your tweets have been shown. Profile visits, how many people have visited your profile. If this is much higher than your new followers, you need to ask why your profile isn't converting. Mentions, how many people have mentioned your brand. More about this later. Top tweet, which of your tweets got seen the most times? Top media tweet, which of your links got seen the most times? Top follower, which of your followers has the most followers and best engagements? Keep this in mind when we get to the section on influencer marketing later on. Top mention, which mention received the most attention and engagement? Use all this information to ascertain which parts of your campaign are working and which need more work. As a result, you can hone your process to ensure that you're maximizing your potential impact.